This is the story of a lonely young boy who had known only sorrow, who had never known joy, who spent each passing day shut away from the light in his own laboratory, where he worked long into the night. Ned was his name, a maker of clocks. He obsessed over their gears, their ticks and their tocks. But this pursuit to control time, his heart led him to follow, had long since turned his life empty and hollow. His focus was slipping, the poor boy came to fear, as he'd been fixing the same clock now for over a year. And where once he found solace in a clock's chiming bell, he felt increasingly hopeless in this clockmaker's hell. That night he brooded, so morose at the table, joined only, as always, by his young sister, Maybel. He watched her, so peaceful, just her and her doll. Not a care in the world. She didn't seem troubled at all. And then came a thought, one entirely new. As Ned pondered in silence, it grew and it grew. Perhaps the perfect clock wasn't all he yearned for. Perhaps he realized he was missing something or someone more. Ned drew up some plans, his biggest ones yet. He had the lab, the tools, but wasn't quite set. He understood mechanics, gears, wrenches, and levers. But now needed dolls for his current endeavors. The nights came and went, though Ned hardly noticed. For the first time in months, he felt lively and focused. The job was too big for one man alone. So he summoned his assistant, Gregory, who called the lab his home. Gregory was faithful, but clumsy, a walking disaster. And he was never quite sure if Ned was his friend or his master. Was assembled, much like an oversized doll, with mechanical innards, for Ned was a clockmaker, after all. The girl was complete. After so much work and preparation, Ned just needed the key to turn on his creation. she shook, and then shuddered as the key found its mark. But then sputtered and died, going out with a spark. Poor Ned was crushed, his hopes up in smoke, the girl of his dreams lying silent and broke. But he wasn't defeated. He'd start over from scratch. He'd made a mistake somewhere that this time he'd catch. GREGORY soldiered on, although deep in his heart, he feared that what they built would drive him and Ned apart. But these fears went unnoticed. On the second attempt, Ned's doll again failed. So much for the girl he had dreamt. This failure was too much for him to bear. He stormed off in a fit to his favorite sulking chair. He huffed and he puffed, his heart racing in his chest, the thump growing louder from deep beneath his breast. That sound, that was it. Now so clear in his head. He couldn't give her life if her insides were dead. He had torn apart dolls for her pieces and parts. But how could he expect her to live without a beating human heart? He knew just the heart to be cut out and sewn, to give life to his creation. He gave her half of his own. One last time, he tried the doll again, and was met one last time with nothing. Ned could hardly believe what he saw with his eyes, what he felt in his hand, and his heart, though half the size. All his work, all his sorrows, no longer suffered in vain. From this moment on, life for Ned and GREGORY would never be the same. He named her Amelia, so pretty, so fair, from her pale, ghostly skin to her red, vibrant hair. He kept her always close, by his side, ever near. So many shades of sadness, so quick to disappear. Ned cherished this time that he spent with Amelia. He didn't even mind that he was flirting with necrophilia. Every day Ned grew closer to Amelia without end. Was a day he grew further from his once only friend. Amelia quickly adapted to her new life in Ned's home. There were times when she almost seemed to have a mind of her own. Through all this, he vowed they'd never be apart. For in both their chests still beat half his heart. She was everything he wanted, this girl was to Ned. And so, he decided they were to be wed. They floated, as if dreaming, through thick and through thin, with her blank, staring eyes and his 100-watt grin. But as the days went by, Ned felt himself growing weak. With only half a heart inside him, his future seemed ever so bleak. He so dearly wanted a companion, this foolish young boy, but had he given half of himself to nothing more than a toy? In her once delicate eyes, he now saw an empty abyss and felt only cold plastic on those lips he had longed to kiss. He had dreamt of a girl so lively and vibrant, but had instead made a doll, stoic and silent. Stood at the altar, Amelia by his side. More beautiful than ever was his silent, gentle bride.
"Are there any objections?"
asked his sister, the priest.
"For if there are, speak now or forever hold your peace."
They would have, if there had been one, perhaps. He took his bride's hand, then took a deep breath, before quietly whispering to Amelia, "I object." The once lifeless doll sank dying to the ground. An open, once silent lips which had made nary a sound. Ned watched in horror, his plan followed through. As with her last breath, Amelia whispered, you. Then came nothing more, and then came nothing less, from the doll in Ned's arms in the white wedding dress. Her silent, still heart, a symbol of his mistake, forever now dormant, crippled from heartbreak. Ned held her cold body, his vision going dark, as the pain overtook his own weakened half heart. Two lives now intertwined in death instead of life. This tormented clockmaker and his broken